Hi everyone, my name is Mark Remke. I'm from the Santa Cruz Bujinkan Dojo, and we're making some short movies here for Ninja Learning Network and Pathways Dojo. Today we're going to focus on the katana, and a lot of people have been calling it in, and they're like, you know, there isn't a lot of sword work that's being taught in the Bujinkan. They do a lot of other things, but nobody's giving us like serious direct how do you cut, how do you block, how do you do all those different things. If you go to Japan, you can ask some of the senseis there and they will show you some good stuff. And so another way to do is maybe go look out a sword school. So Enshin Itto Ryu Battojutsu is one of the sword schools that I've went and played with and got to show some of the forms. And I think this is a really cool school because the heritage comes from the samurai tradition. And so a lot of what ninjutsu and ninjas were doing back in the day was trying to learn how to defend against things. So it's an interesting thing to go to basic training of sword school, and that's exactly how these forms are taught. So I'm going to show you the most basic form in four directions that will help improve your sword skills immensely. The name of the form is called Shohatto, and it basically puts a lot of our simple sword things together, which is a basic draw cut, a basic cut, and then learning the terminology for putting away a sword. And they have another term for flicking off blood and guts of cleaning it. Even though there's a thing with that I'd love to talk about, it's called chiburi. Chiburi is to wipe away the blood and guts off a sword, and mostly it's done from a flicking motion. But I went to a sword specialist, and they said back in the day, if they ever did really cut through something, no matter what it was, they would always take a cloth and take the sword and wipe it off. And there's a reason for that. If you had just put it back into your saya, then you would have this sticky substance in there. And after a while, the wood in here will swell, and you'll have all sorts of problems extracting your sword for a draw. So they would never just put it back in. But in Iaido, the drawing and putting away of a sword, they don't cut through things. That's a whole different section when they have that type of a sword. So for learning how to do quick draws, learning your cuts, learning your blocks, this is a really good thing to practice. So I'll go ahead and show you the form. The first way we do it is in a forward motion. So I'll just turn slightly, but I'm going in a forward motion here. I'm wearing my sword at a 45 degree angle on my belt. The blade edge is facing up. I have my thumb on the tsuba to begin with. And as I step forward to do the first draw, nuki uchi, my hand comes up from my side. And what's interesting is with this actual step, my sword that was at a 45 turns straight. So now I am squared off with my opponent forward. As I draw and come out and square my shoulders off, I've gone completely one cut through the person. Not all the way out here with all this wasted space, but just through, and then still pointing at my opponent in case I need to come in and stab a second time. So nuki uchi is this draw. As I come out, nuki uchi. This is the first move. The second move, turning here at this angle for you, I am going to turn my saya back up into its original position. As I step up, feet together, and my hands come up. Then I'm going to step forward and cut down in kiri oroshi. Then I'm going to put my left hand back on the saya and push it into a downward position as I turn my hand out at a 45 degree angle. From there, we come up, then we take the sword at a 45, chiburi, come back up into this position, and then noto, putting the sword away. So this particular part, I just come together and turn my saya to the side. The tip touches the koi uchi of the saya. I pinch with the thumb and the forefinger, pull this back as my hip turns, and then bring the saya out to the sword, trap it, and seat it back into my waist again. So now that was an explanation of it. I'll just flow through the form for you. Shohatto. This form has all of the elements in it that you will need: a draw, a cut, and then all of the beautiful parts of putting it away. So there's a lot of tradition that goes behind these movements, and it makes you feel really good as a martial artist to have this precision that comes with these movements. The other parts of this form are the same thing. We're just doing a little bit different footwork to step out in the four directions. So the first one was forward with Shohatto. The next one is the same thing, but at first I turn to the right. So from here, I do my bow, I come out. And then I turn before I do my other bow. This is just the tradition. Of course, in real life, we're just gonna turn, handle it, and then be scanning and looking for other people. The second or third way, sorry, is to the left. Now my left foot opens up first on this one after the bow. And then I turn again and bow. The last one is to the rear. And so I'll show this from a front perspective first, and then I'll turn around so you can see a little bit of difference. So on this one, I'm going to bow, and as I come up from the bow, my right leg will shoot backwards at a 45-degree angle across behind my other leg. So from Shizen, I take a step back and cross. Then I get my hand ready in position, and as I turn and cut, my feet now are in a perfect 1 foot forward stance. I'm not overextended and I'm not underextended. I'm in a perfect stance from here at the right distance. Then I finish up the form. And as I get ready for the bow, I turn around and then bow. So I'll show you that same form again, starting from facing Shohatto. All right, so these are the four directions of Shohatto. This is a basic form that I learned, and this will help you immensely with your sword work. Try this form standing, and then we'll go into an advanced one in the next one from kneeling. This becomes a whole nother level of sword work because you have to learn how to come up out of your seated position. So have fun with this. Good luck cutting.